Welcome to Chem Help ASAP. The title says it all. Carbonyl compounds are very common electrophiles. Carbonyls are electrophiles. A neutral carbonyl, like a ketone, which we show on the left, is a weak electrophile. We can think of the carbon as being electron poor because of the polarized CO pi bond. So we have a partial plus on carbon. That's a weak electrophile. To attack a weak electrophile, we need a strong nucleophile. It's easy to hear strong nucleophile and think SN2. But our strong nucleophiles for attacking a carbonyl will be somewhat different from our SN2 nucleophiles. In the presence of acid, we can protonate a carbonyl oxygen. So show this towards the right. It's our acid. And here is our protonated carbonyl. We can draw another resonance form by breaking the CO pi bond, and that gives us a carbocation instead. The O plus resonance form is the major contributor because it satisfies the octet rule, but the carbocation is still a minor contributor and does explain the strong electrophilicity of a protonated carbonyl. To attack a strong electrophile, we're talking about the carbon right here, to attack a strong electrophile, we need a weak nucleophile. Molecules like water and alcohols, among others. These are the two forms of electrophilicity that we'll see in carbonyls, a weak electrophile or a strong electrophile. I tend to emphasize the weak electrophile form in organic 1 and then cover the strong electrophile form in organic 2. Your instructor will have his or her own preferences. Let's cover the weak electrophile a bit more before we finish. So let's assume we have an aldehyde. We're on the top left. The carbonyl, a weak electrophile, can be attacked by a strong nucleophile. The nucleophile attacks. The carbon breaks the pi bond and pushes the electrons on oxygen to make an anion. The anion in the middle of the screen has a special name, the tetrahedral intermediate. This intermediate doesn't have much it can do, so it will remain in the solution, the reaction solution, until we add a proton source, often water. We then protonate the O minus to get an alcohol. We've broken a pi bond and performed a nucleophilic addition. We've added a nucleophile. Now let's assume we have an acid derivative, specifically an ester. Now we're on the lower left. Esters are also weak electrophiles because they have a carbonyl. A strong nucleophile can attack, break the pi bond, push the electrons up on oxygen, and form a tetrahedral intermediate. This tetrahedral intermediate has a potential leaving group in the OR prime group of the ester. The O minus can swing a lone pair of electrons down and kick out this OR prime group. This forms a new carbonyl compound. The overall reaction here is not a nucleophilic addition. Instead, it is a nucleophilic substitution because we have replaced one group, the OR prime group, with our nucleophile. The first step was an addition, and the second step was an elimination to reform the pi bond. So, here is a fundamental reactivity difference between a simple carbonyl, an aldehyde or ketone, and the carbonyl of an acid derivative. We will see these reactions over and over again to reinforce these concepts.